I was also remembering various things that I come across as I go about in my life running a company. I read this after Fukushima about how the Japanese started coping with the big energy shortage. The Japanese are very formal. They all wear suits, ties, and all that. So what they did was, it was summer, so they put off their air conditioning. In some cases, they increased the temperature from what used to be 24, 25 to about 28, 30. And asked people to be informally dressed in whatever way they're feeling comfortable. And they did that, and in winter, they actually lowered the temperature so they don't have to heat it that much, and passed around blankets for people to cover their legs so that they don't feel too cold. So this is some way a country has responded to a problem. So we need to bring in change at multiple levels. At the individual levels, we make the choices to take public transport. That is something I feel very inspired by. Buy an electric car, maybe. I'm still looking at the opportunity to buy a car and see how it works. Right now, I'm driving a gas guzzler, and I'm feeling bad about that standing here. Turning away from bottled water. Somebody made that choice recently. I heard that I will not drink bottled water. So at an individual level, you can do many, many things to, you know, reduce your footprint, reduce your carbon footprint. And not only at the individual level, at an organization level, and this is where businesses have created a lot of environmental damage. Many, many big environmental tragedies can be traced to organizations and companies organizing their factories and things like that. So business is a source of many problems, but at the same time, we can also be part of the solution. And there are many good examples of how companies have reinvented themselves by committing themselves to a path of sustainability. Small things can make a big difference. So you talked about government support. Actually, I find that the government support is very good in this country for solar power. Solar power is at par with grid costs today, or even lesser in some places. Just moved last year to solar power in wherever it was possible. We're still on that journey. Today, 5% of our energy is solar, which is a large number, but the 5% is a small fraction of what we consume. And we've committed ourselves to say that we'll take it to 20% by next year. And we're on that path. We are converting all our car parks to solar generating stations. All our rooftops are going to be used for generating solar energy. Open land around our factories. A whole lot of work is going on. We're also moving away from fossil fuels to renewable fuels. We moved all our major boilers from coal to biomass, renewable biomass like rice husk and all of that. We still have the carbon cycle there. We don't completely get off that, but at least it's much better than a fossil fuel, because the crop acts as a sink for carbon dioxide and then again releases it as you burn it. So it's not possible for companies or organizations anymore to ignore this huge pressure on them. Of course, it's pressure from outside, but also there is a moral imperative for us as people, as businessmen, to reinvent ourselves, to become more environmentally friendly, to be a force for good in society, to impact everything positively. So it gives me a lot of pleasure for us to be here. We are very proud to be part of the support system for WWF. We've, in a small way, done some stuff in the Sri Salem forest to, you know, generate water for the animals during the lean periods. We're also trying to see how we can grow, and as an organization, we have to grow, and that is our part of our mandate that our shareholders give us, so we have to keep growing. But how do we de-link growth from environmental impact? How do we generate increased profits but invest back in societies? How do we become greener in what we do? How do we use less resources? How do we move our manufacturing from a linear cycle to a closed loop manufacturing? How do we look at circular manufacturing, where our, you know, our inputs come from somewhere else, and then our outputs are recycled, byproducts are brought in, and we generate energy as we produce. These are all monumental challenges for industry, but they're worthy challenges. Capitalism is not about greed. It's not about extractive, businesses. It is about actually making a difference to all our stakeholders, and doing that without trading one constituency against other. It doesn't mean that we sacrifice growth, but we grow, but grow in a sustainable way. Create a positive impact in your communities, on the environment, and still grow. And this is what we need to do at an organization level. We have to do things at we need to change at an individual level, at an organization level, and also as a society. And that is where this event comes in. How do we bring in awareness into the entire society, into the city, into the country, into the whole planet, that what we are doing is not sustainable, and what we all need to make changes in everything that we do. So the media is a powerful constituency. You can change perspectives. What you do has a huge impact on us. So, you can use your power to transform societies. And, I request you to do your bit to help us change this world and make it a better place for the future generations, like everybody said. Thank you very much.